Erkan, Martin was already mentioning, so we are using C++ to control memory management. And I would like to give a very brief lightning talk about some memory issue we experienced, I would say, with the last major release, where we changed a bit our multi-threading handling and got the feedback that it suddenly our program reads way more memory than before. And this was surprising to us, and of course we were expecting a memory leak. We're investigating with Wargrind, couldn't find anything, spent our days, and now I would like to show you the reason why we experienced this issue and why this maybe also could be relevant for you if you have long-running processes on the Linux. So just the laptop fall asleep. So. Wrong password, that's not great. Okay, so I prepared a tiny example program to demonstrate the issue. So, still wrong window. Okay, no. And what we have here, let's make it bigger. We have two workers. One is a worker which always allocates 100 megabytes and immediately frees it again and allocates it again and does this 10 times. And we have another worker which allocates only 30 megabytes of data and frees it again and does this also 10 times. Okay. And here around I have some code which allows me to start the workers in different threads. Okay. So now we have to get it big again. And here on the left I have HTOP to show the memory consumption. Okay, so now if I start the program with, let's say, one thread and also one worker with the 100 megabyte worker. So it does its work. We should see here, yeah, consumes some memory. And after it's done, it has basically 2 megabytes of resident memory. So nothing to worry about. Okay, so we can stop the program. Now we can also can do this with, let's say, 20 threads. The behavior in the end is the same. It just allocates more memory during the run. But in the end, we should still have only quite little memory consumption. So, 3 megabytes. That's totally fine, I would say. Now we come to the interesting part, and that's if we do allocations with 13 megabytes. And let's say, let's do 30 threads. So now it does quite some work, so it's done. And now the program has finished, and all the memory should have been cleared. But still the process needs almost 1 gigabyte. And that was quite surprising to us because we thought, okay, it's C++ and we handed back all the memory and we should be fine, it's not Java. So we started investigating the issues and luckily malloc has the function malloc stats, which allows you to get some information about what's actually going on there. So, and we can print out that with S here. And we see malloc actually in the newer versions creates several arenas. And the arena was, or the arenas were introduced to reduce memory contention so that not every allocation goes to the same point and addresses the same lock, but that they have multiple of arenas and reduce this contention. But unfortunately, every arena also keeps some memory up. And that's what's actually causing this problem. So they are holding this memory. And they say, okay, We have this mostly 13 megabytes from the system, but we actually barely use any of them. And then we Googled a bit further and found, okay, there's malloc trim. And we had higher hopes there, so that it actually releases all the memory. And I can call this now with T. Okay, we see, oh, there was only a tiny effect, so it was only reduced by 30 megabytes. And that's because malloc trim actually only trims the main arena, arena zero. And we haven't found a way to actually trim all the other arenas. So, and...
Sorry, at this point, all of these threads are still running?
No, they are done. So, they are joined, and it's completely gone. And another interesting information is that there are actually 8 times the number of cores arena maximum. So there is an upper limit. I mean, this is what we can run here now. So we see almost 2 gigabytes of memory consumption. So that's what's actually causing the issue for us, because we were expecting very tiny processes here, long-running processes, but over time they consumed or grew all the memory. That's 2.23 on an Ubuntu 16 running.
Have you tried like a newer version of Libc, because like 16 was 21?
Yeah, and what we did, because we were under time pressure and usually we have no influence on the system our customers are running on, we just used a different malloc implementation. Okay. So, but would be interesting what's now going on. Actually, we used TPB because that's what we had in place and was very easy for us to use at that time. We were under pressure. Okay, and with that, I would like to conclude my talk. You had a question? Which version you mean? Or so you can give actually, you can hand in a lot of parameters. You can also configure the amount of arenas. You could limit that. But we decided against it because it's very system dependent. And we wanted a general solution because our software has to run on the Windows, Mac, and all kind of Linux distributions. So there's another question. Good point. That's something I forgot to mention. The 100 megabytes or larger amount of memories are handled differently by malloc. So they go directly to nmap call and is immediately released when it's freed again. Okay, then that's it. I think now there is pizza. Thank you.